Beneath the 600 meters of ice below me is the most essential point of all. While it's true that still waters run deep, the craziest things can be found in ocean waves. The seas of the Earth are surely immense and enigmatic. As a result, it is not a surprise that when people have studied them, they have discovered some rather weird things. Previous studies have revealed that the aquatic depths below the Antarctic ice shelves are too cold and nutrient-poor to sustain much life. However, a new study published by Elon Musk challenges scholars' view of the existence of life in severe conditions by unveiling the discovery of a colony of animals on the seafloor. These animals aren't supposed to be alive there, and we have finally captured them on record. What exactly did researchers find in the far depths of the ocean, and why does this discovery have them scurrying for answers? Join us as we examine the impossible findings made in the Arctic. A U.S. submarine made history in 1958 when it plunged beneath the ice to become the first boat to reach the North Pole. Scientists now have a whole new planet to examine, due to its mission. Nowadays, nuclear-powered submarines are stealthy weapons of destruction and deterrence that can travel with torpedoes and nuclear missiles for months at a time. For instance, the UK has constantly maintained at least one submarine with nuclear weapons at sea since 1969. The expedition was also a scientific milestone that helped pave the way for a new age of research and discovery about the peculiar habitat beneath the Arctic ice. It acted as a test bed for the military potential of nuclear submarines. Both the Navy and scientists obtain a fresh understanding of the Arctic Ocean and the environment in which they operate with the employment of submarines. Not only is Antarctica the coldest region, but it also has the most mysteries to be revealed. There is still a treasure mine of unusual and spectacular anomalies beneath the ice and seas just waiting to be unearthed. Despite its seclusion and foreboding temperature, nothing is simple when you're in the heart of the Filchneron ice shelf, 5 hours flying from the closest base in Antarctica. Geologist James Smith of the British Antarctic Survey endured nearly 3 months of sub-zero conditions, sleeping in a tent and eating dried food. Even though it was the southern summer, he needed seafloor sediment, which was locked under a half mile of ice, to examine the history of the floating shelf. But the science itself was a pain. Smith and his colleagues had to melt 20 tons of snow to make 20,000 liters of hot water, which they then poured through a pipe drop down a borehole. To approach it, they had to chisel away at the ice for 20 hours before they could ultimately break through the shelf. They then lowered a GoPro camera and equipment to capture the sediment, but the collector returned empty-handed. They gave it another shot, still barren again. Nothing is simple in this case. The instrument's round journeys took 1 hour. Later that evening, Smith watched the tape in his tent and spotted a very evident flaw. The video displays a plummet through 3,000 feet of bluish-green ice that abruptly ends and gives way to the deep ocean. Before the bottom, largely light-colored silt, which Smith was after, something dark can be seen on the coast. Another 1,600 feet down, that enigmatic object turned out to be a boulder, which the camera photographs as it crashes face-first into the sediment. The camera instantly corrects itself and scans the rock, exposing something completely different from what the geologists were seeking. In truth, it was something exceedingly unlikely: they found life. There is only one enormous boulder in the center of the mostly level seafloor. It's not like the ocean floor is covered in garbage of this nature. Just his luck, Smith chose the incorrect area to drill. Smith is not a biologist, but his British Antarctic Survey colleague Hugh Griffiths is. Griffiths spotted a kind of film on the rock when he watched the video from the UK, which was presumably a covering of microorganisms turned a microbial mat, while sturdier cylindrical sponges grabbed the surface. A sponge that looked like an alien and other stalking animals hung from the rock. Wispy filaments that may have been part of the bacterial mats or maybe the bizarre hydroid animal littered the rock. The nearest edge of the shelf, where the ice terminates and the open ocean begins, is 160 miles from the rock Smith accidentally found. The closest place that might function as a source of food is hundreds of kilometers distant. This region would have adequate sunshine to maintain an ecosystem and be in the appropriate position with relation to the rock for known currents to feed these species. As you travel farther away from open water and sunlight, all life becomes less abundant. According to current hypotheses on what animals could dwell beneath ice shelves, small mobile scavengers and predators such as fish, worms, jellyfish, or krill have been detected in similar settings in past investigations. However, it was anticipated that filter-feeding animals, which depend on an outside supply of food, would be among the first to drown. Yet, it has no business being here. "It's not the most exciting-looking rock if you don't know where it is," adds Griffiths. "Given that you are aware of it now, your jaw may be close to the floor at this moment." How they get there is merely one of the many questions that this find poses. What do they consume? They have been there for how long? How frequently do these covered boulders occur in nature? Are these the same species that we witness outside of the ice shelf, or are they a separate species? And in the case that the ice shelf fell, what would happen to these communities? These organisms are living in utter darkness, which is fantastic because many deep-sea critters also do the same thing. However, organisms that spend sessile, immobile lifestyles on the deep-sea floor must rely on a rather consistent source of food in the form of marine snow. Every living thing that is currently swimming in the water column above will someday pass away and sink to the bottom of the ocean. Other species nibble at the remains as they fall and begin to decompose and spit out fragments, microscopic bits that gather even on the lowest sea levels. This is effective in the majority of regions near Antarctica where the oceans are particularly productive. All species of fish, which in turn feed enormous marine mammals like seals, are fed by small organisms known as plankton. All of this activity results in detritus and dead organisms, which eventually transform into marine snow. However, the Antarctic species that occupy this particular rock don't exist beneath an active water column. They are buried behind a mile of solid ice. Moreover, they are unable to leave their rock in quest of food. According to Griffiths, being something that's attached to the spot in a place where there isn't much food and it is highly sporadic is the worst thing. Therefore, how on earth could they be feeding themselves? The food source is going horizontally rather than vertically, according to the experts, who believe it is likely that the drift of this marine snow has been turned on its side. The researchers revealed that there are profitable spots between 390 and 930 kilometers away after reviewing current charts around the drill site. Even while it might not be much, it's feasible that hundreds of miles worth of organic material are flowing via these currents to support these species. Given that marine snow created at the surface must plummet 7 miles to reach the sea floor in the deepest section of the ocean, the Challenger Deep near Guam, the distance is amazing. Food would have to travel up to 133 times that far, and it would have to do so by floating sideways to get to the animals on this Antarctic rock, according to Rich Moo, curator of invertebrate zoology and geology at the California Academy of Sciences, who has studied Antarctic sea life but wasn't involved in this new experiment. This isn't very far-fetched given what scientists know about currents near Antarctica. Sea water in the vicinity becomes denser as it cools, according to Moo. It drops to the ocean floor and radiates outward from the Antarctic, and many, if not almost all, of the current systems in the world are generated from these currents. Something needs to fill the gap left behind when the water flows outward. There's going to be some inflow to replace that, adds Moo, and that inflow will carry organic materials even over hundreds of kilometers. This would offer sustenance for our life forms who were imprisoned on that boulder. Additionally, the currents could introduce new species to the animal life on the rock. However, because they were unable to acquire samples, the researchers are still unaware of the precise diet of these sponges and other species. While some sponges are carnivorous and prey on small organisms, others filter organic detritus from the water. That would be sort of your headline of the year, says Christopher Marr, a marine biologist at the Smithsonian who wasn't involved in the research, killer sponges living in the dark, cold recesses of Antarctica where no life can survive. Since the camera didn't catch any fish or crustaceans, Griffiths and his team are also unsure if other mobile species like fish and crustaceans also inhabit the area around the rock, making it unclear whether the sessile animals are subject to predation. Do they all consume the same kind of food, or do some of them maybe share nutrients? Or are there extra traveling creatures nourishing this colony in any way? Only a separate travel can bring the answers to these difficulties. the animals don't appear to be in danger of getting buried because it does seem that the sedimentation surrounding the rock isn't very heavy. It's kind of a Goldilocks-type thing going on, says Griffiths of the rock's fortuitous placement where it's got just enough food coming in and it's got nothing that wants to eat them, as far as we can tell, and it's not getting buried by too much sediment. The discovery of ripples, which are normally formed by currents in the sediment surrounding the rock, corroborated the concept that food was delivered here from a distance. Furthermore, it's unknown how these immobile animals first came. Was it something that happened very locally where they simply hopped from one local boulder to another? Alternatively, their parents were likely on a rock thousands of kilometers distant where a more typical marine environment begins, and the ice shelf ends, and they discharge their sperm and eggs to drift in the currents. Griffiths and his colleagues are unable to estimate the age of these animals since they lack specimens. Given the extended lifespans of Antarctic sponges, it's plausible that this ecosystem is exceedingly old. The rock may have been imbued with life long ago, but currents have also injected fresh life into it through the years. Elon Musk, the researchers, and others are unable to tell whether this rock is an oddity or if similar ecosystems are usual beneath the ice. These animal populations might not merely have happened by chance when the scientists set their cameras onto the rock. Perhaps they are a common sight on the seafloor beneath Antarctica's ice sheets. There would be adequate space for such ecosystems in the 560,000 square kilometers of these floating ice shelves. However, only a space the size of a tennis court has been investigated under them by scientists using earlier boreholes. It is therefore feasible that there are many, and we haven't yet identified them. This is the first reported account of a hard substrate community, that is a boulder community, deep beneath an ice shelf, and it seems to challenge all earlier ideas regarding the forms of life that would be able to endure there. The researchers believe that this colony might be up to 1,500 kilometers upstream from the nearest source of photosynthesis based on the local water currents. However, until the researchers have the technology to obtain samples of these species, a big difficulty in itself, they won't know more about these animals. Other creatures are also known to get nutrients from glacial melts or chemicals from methane seeps. Furthermore, using a huge hot water drill, researchers uncovered a never-before-seen ecology that dwells in an underground river beneath the icy surface of the Larsen Ice Shelf. The covert habitat is located in a huge chamber that is about 1,640 feet, 500 meters, below the ice's surface. After discovering a strange groove in a satellite shot of the ice sheet, scientists uncovered the subsurface structure, but they never expected to find anything within. When they eventually dug down to explore it, instead, the crew discovered tens of thousands of little amphipod crustaceans, which had them jumping up and down for delight. Scientists now have the most in-depth understanding of the seafloor surrounding Antarctica, including its deepest point, the Factorian Deep, owing to a new map of the Southern Ocean. The Factorian Deep was newly found in 2019. It lies at a depth of around 24,400 feet, 7,437 meters, below the ocean surface or 17 Empire State Buildings stacked top to bottom. But up until this moment, scientists were unclear about how it interacted with the neighboring seafloor. The new map, which covers more than 18.5 million square miles, 48 million square kilometers, of the sea bottom, is based on more than 1,200 sonar data sets, the majority of which were gathered by science vessels. The sea bottom map will be used by researchers to find any seamounts or underwater mountains that might be marine life hotspots. We need to figure out a means to interact closely with these animals and their surroundings to receive the answers to our queries, said one researcher. We might be out of time to accomplish this. Despite being covered behind a half mile of ice, this rock is increasingly in danger owing to global warming. The future collapse of some of these massive ice shelves could result in the loss of a particular biosphere. Thwaites Glacier in Antarctica, commonly known as the Doomsday Glacier, was discovered by underwater robots to be clinging to the seafloor by its fingernails. Once it divides, it may meet its end sooner than projected because of its swift speed and a sharp rise in ice loss during previously unreported stages of fast retreat. Within the previous several millennia, the glacier scraped down the ocean floor, leaving behind a sequence of parallel grooves, according to a new map of the seafloor encircling the glacial giant. Researchers noted that high heat brought on by climate change could bring about this kind of rapid melting once more. Thanks for watching another episode of Worldview Theory. While you're still here, make sure to click the thumbnail on your screen for more fantastic videos.